Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have a brand new guitar to show you. Today I'm going to be unboxing the brand new Epiphone 1961 Les Paul Standard SG. Let's do it. Now, for the regulars out there on the PMTVUK channel, you might know that my favourite guitar of all time is the Gibson SG. That body shape is just the coolest thing in the world, and the first time I ever saw a guitar was Angus Young on the TV. I was like, I want to play guitar, and it's got devil horns, it's amazing. I always have my SGs close by, and this lovely thing is the latest incarnation of the classic. Now, it's called the Les Paul because back in, guitar picks make great scissors as well, like knives and stuff. Back in 1960, the Les Paul went away for a bit. It was discontinued. The Les Paul was actually discontinued. And in 1961, they brought out the new Les Paul, but it looked like this. Well, that body shape. Anyways, Les Paul didn't like it. So later on, it was changed. So you can see like on the old 1961 reissues, like this one by Epiphone, it'll say Les Paul on the little neck plate heel. That's why it says it, because it was a Les Paul. Then changed to SG, solid guitar, and the Les Paul came back at a later date. Before that, you could only kind of get, I didn't know the case was going to be brown. I didn't know you could get, well, you couldn't get a proper SG, or Les Paul, should I say, from Epiphone. There's been a couple different incarnations, but this is something quite special. Let me just rearrange my stuff. I'll be back in a second. So this is the first time, these have been getting released today, which is the, what day is it, Alex? 13th? 14th of December, which is very, very, very cool. Just before Christmas. So it comes in a case, beautiful brown Epiphone case. And I'm gonna say, actually no, let's open it together. Let's open this together. It's pink inside, and that, ladies and gentlemen, is a 1961 Les Paul in all of its glory. I'm sure they didn't have silica gel back in 1961 though. So, for people out there that aren't as nerdy as me, and think an SG is just an SG, obviously the body shape, this classic double horn design, is iconic. But there's been a few different variants over the years. It got really crazy in the 70s and everything got really thick. But the carves are different. 61 have different carves to the modern day standards. There were different variants in the 80s. And all the carves and the contours of this lovely guitar are all period correct to 1961. That's new. Inspired by Gibson on the back. How cool is that? Let's plonk it here next to my SGs. Actually, let's put it there first. And then I'll see what comes in the case. So the case is beautiful. Pink inside, just like the original ones back in the day. In the little mirror here, you have the classic Epiphone sticker. Some new things, which I haven't really seen before. All the hang tags. Little Epiphone, what look like the stickers, but they look like little transferable tattoos. Like little guitar pick. A more historic Epiphone. For every stage, an early access ticket. Again, all the hang tags. And a little pamphlet for the Gibson app, which has a tuner on, you can learn songs from Gibson artists, and all that kind of jazz. Right, I'll put those back in the little box in a second. Let's talk about the guitar. Lovely and lightweight, I've got to say. Very, very lightweight. And again, I know 61 SGs very, very well, and that is a 61 profile neck. Differs to your modern day slim taper, SG standard necks. It's got a very not unique feel. It still feels like a proper Gibson, Epiphone, I guess, but it's, yeah, it's there. It's very, very cool. So specs what make this unique. Two piece mahogany body. It comes in white as well, which I absolutely adore. I've always loved white SGs. So the fact this comes in white is just fantastic. I thought I'd choose red for the video because it's an SG, isn't it? So two-piece mahogany body, set mahogany neck, and again, that beautiful 61 profile neck. 12-inch radius fingerboard, it's fully bound. You've got the trapezoid inlays. The fretboard is Indian laurel, not rosewood, as it was in 1961. Now, before people get their back up about that, Indian laurel is a bit lighter, obviously, than rosewood, as you can see, But it has the same tonal properties. It's, before people start talking about tone woods, tone woods are a thing. I wholly believe that. When you play as many guitars as you do working in a guitar store, tone woods are a thing, especially in the feel. So rosewood is very soft, and this has a lovely soft feel under your fingertips. But it's more sustainable than rosewood, and a bit more cost effective, I guess. So this keeps the price down on this. Well, to buy a custom shop 61 is thousands, to buy an original 61 is loads of thousands. So yeah, doesn't bother me. 22 frets. Up on the truss rod cover, it says Les Paul, for the reasons I was stating before. You've got the vintage style Gibson / Epiphone Deluxe tuners on the new Kalamazoo headstock. So it's a bit more Gibson inspired than previous Epiphones, which I think plays a lot into guitar players. I believe guitar playing is very much in your head. So when you look down and you see a headstock that looks more like a Gibson and you haven't paid Gibson money to it, Gibson money for it, it kind of makes you play a bit differently. I think it's really cool. The finish as well, you might notice, isn't super shiny, like poly. I think it is still polyurethane lacquer, but it's kind of more satin, so it gives the illusion of nitrocellulose, but without having to spend lots of crazy money. Multiply pickguard as well, again akin to the original 1961. A bit more intense than your standard Epiphone SG. Three-way switch, CTS pots, so the best of the best. Pickups though. These, ladies and gentlemen, are Gibson burst buckers. There's a Gibson burst bucker 2 in the bridge and a 3 in the neck, or the other way around. I can't remember off the top of my head, but yes. Proper Gibson pickups in this glorious guitar. They're very simple guitars for how amazing they are. I think that's all the specs. Who's ready to hear it? I know I am. I'm going to use two tech cables into this Fender Tone Master Super Reverb with a Blackstar Depth 10 dual drive, giving us all the grit. I can't wait to play it. Let's do it. This plays like an old school SG. I mean, I was hopping on about that 61 profile neck before, and it is called a Slim Taper C, but the Slim Taper neck is coined from this whole, the 60s Gibsons. It's thinner than the 50s. 50s are big, Slim Taper is more 60s. But when it's joined to all the SG accoutrements of a 61, I don't know, it just makes you feel like you're playing a 61 SG, which is kind of what you are, but for not a lot of money. Mallory capacitors as well, so very fancy controls with size of CTS pots. Gibson burst pickers are really responsive, like to how to the dynamics of your picking style, how hard you pick, how light you pick. They come great with the volume or, yeah, your picking dynamic. creamy sounding neck pickup. Now let's finally hear it with some clean tones. Neck pickup sounds the best though by far. I love burst pickup neck pickups. Stop playing it. So that, ladies and gents, is the awesome new Epiphone, inspired by Gibson, as that nice little plaque says. Now on the back, 1961 Les Paul Standard. SG, solid guitar. A really cool throwback, which is a bit more honest to the real 1961s from back in the day. A guitar that started it all for me and a lot of our guitar heroes. Iommi, what was I on? Angus Young, the reason I play SGs, Robbie Krieger, and so many more. Please comment down below your favorite SG player, and if you can't wait to get your hands on this magnificent guitar. Epiphone, you've done it again. Bravo. If you enjoyed this video, please hit like down below and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more info on the 1961 Les Paul Standard by Epiphone, click the link in the description box down below. It'll take you to the page of PMTOnline.co.uk. There's also links for the entire rig I've been playing in today's video. Or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.